Subscribe our channel, press the bell icon for latest videos.
Hi friends, here in this video we are going to see the effect of reactive gyroscopic couple in case of ships. And for that, here we have the given condition. Let's get started. When the rotor rotates in clockwise direction and the ship is steering to the left, for that we have to find the effect of reactive gyroscopic couple. At first, there is an axis about which the rotor is rotating. I'll extend the axis. Then I'll give the parts of the ship. Looking from the front portion is called as bow or fore end. The rear part is called as stern or aft. Looking from the stern, the right hand part of the ship is called as starboard side, and the left part is called as the port end or port side. Next, how to start the given problem? For that, first start with the rotation, that is the rotor is rotating in a clockwise direction as mentioned. Using the right hand rule, curl the fingers of the right hand along the direction of this rotor. So I am curling it in a clockwise direction, and the thumb is showing the velocity vector, and that velocity vector is to be plotted over here. Again, I'll explain how to get this direction. Curl the fingers of the right hand in a clockwise direction like given into the problem, because rotor is in clockwise direction and thumb would indicate the velocity vector. So this is going towards the ship. Next, it is steering to the left. So for that, we have to imagine that we are into the ship and it is moving towards the left side, taking a left turn. Now when the ship is taking a left turn, it is rotating about a vertical axis, which is called as the precession axis. This is the precession axis. When it is taking a left turn, it is rotating about the precession axis in this direction, that is the direction of omega p, precessional angular velocity. And as we can see, there are rotations about two different axes. One is the spin axis, other is the precession axis. So because of that, there is a gyroscopic effect. And how to get that? This vector of omega would be tilted by 90 degrees in a direction which is similar to this omega p. Like looking from top, omega p is rotating in an anti-clockwise direction. So this omega needs to be tilted in an anti-clockwise manner in a plane. So when I'm tilting this omega along the direction of angular velocity of precession, that is an anti-clockwise direction looking from top, I get the active gyroscopic couple. And just opposite to it, onto the same line, there will be reactive gyroscopic couple. So once I get the reactive gyroscopic couple, it is the vector which is showing the direction. So matching the right hand thumb with the direction of this reactive gyroscopic couple vector, the curling fingers show the direction of reactive gyroscopic couple, that is this direction. Again, point the thumb in the direction of the reactive gyroscopic couple and the curling fingers show the reactive gyroscopic couple. This same couple would be transferred to the ship. So when it is transferred to the ship, the effect is so here the effect is bow or fore end is dipped. As we can see, this arrow is dipping the fore end, whereas the stern or aft is raised because the couple is acting in this direction. So that is the reactive gyroscopic couple effect when the ship having rotor rotating in a clockwise direction and it is taking a left turn, the forend gets dipped and the stern gets raised. So that was the given condition. At the end, if you'll find my videos helpful, you'll can like, share, comment and subscribe our channel. At the same time, share it amongst your family and friends. Thanks for watching.